This video tells you how to make a simple aimbot within 100 lines of Python code using TensorFlow Hub. Before start, I want to tell you something. First, this is developed in Windows, so Linux users should find another approach for raw mouse input. And I'm not going to do training or doing something complex deep learning techniques. But with TensorFlow Hub, I will load a pre-trained model and make a simple aimbot. Since it does not train with a well-prepared dataset, its accuracy will be very low. But I just want to focus on how to use TensorFlow Hub and some tips about making a bot. My plan is very simple. First, load detection model from TensorFlow Hub. Second, get a screen and pre-process and give it to the detector. Third, calculate the distance between crosshair and detected objects. Finally, move mouse and shoot. So simple, right? So let's get started. Here are the library requirements. PyAutoGUI is a very convenient library to get a screenshot. PyAutoGUI also provides mouse input, but usually a FPS game has an anti-cheat program, so it blocks every input from other programs. So we need these Windows 32 libraries. As I mentioned in the beginning, Linux users should find another way to use low input of mouse. First, let's choose a detection model. You can find TensorFlow models from TensorFlow Hub website. You will see many problems, but what we want is image problem and object detection. There are several architectures, and we can see comparison table of TensorFlow models. My laptop is not good, so I used CenterNet LessNet 50 for speed, but you can try any model you want. When you click the model, you will see the example. And you should carefully watch what type of tensor is used and how shape looks like. Let's copy load section and get into the code. And this is for image scale. Since my laptop is not good, so I'm going to resize and use 1/3 of image. Next, we get a screen image. You can easily get your screen using pyautogui.screenshot function. If you want to get an entire screen of yours, there should be no parameter. In my case, I use window display mode to show what is going on my code, so I needed to get an exact window rectangle. Window 32 GUI can help this problem. With a caption of window, we can get positions of each corner. PyAutoGUI will take region parameter, which consists of x, y, width, and height. PyAutoGUI screenshot function will return an array of image. As we saw on TensorFlow Hub website, this model will take this tensor structure. So we need to change and add one more dimension in the first position using NumPy expand dimensions. I saved width and height for calculating distance between crosshair and object later. When we pass a tensor to detector, we will get a result consists of boxes, scores, and classes. So what we want is to get only boxes that detect a human. So let's loop every boxes we have with these conditions. This model is trained with COCO dataset, therefore there are 80 classes. We need just human, and human's class number is 1. Score shows how likely it is. Since we did not train with custom dataset, score must be low, so I just set 0.5 as a threshold. I just add this condition because sometimes detector detects a hand as a human, so I simply just ignore this area. And the last, if the detector detects more than one object, we need to calculate distance and choose which object we want to shoot first. I calculated each distance between crosshair, which locate in the center, and object. Since we just have a position of center, I added this for headshot. So now we have pixel distance of x and y. Final step is moving mouse and shooting. As I mentioned before, we have to use Win32 API for mouse input. But mouse movement is not exactly same with pixel difference. What does it mean that even if you move mouse 100 pixels, Crosshair will not move exactly 100 pixels in the game. We have to figure out by doing some trial and error. In my case, multiplying by 1.7 showed quite good result. Since I resized 1/3, I multiplied it again. So after that, win32api.mouseEventFunction, move mouse and click to shoot. And let's run and check. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video.